Morning students, I hope you understand what I taught in the last class. So we are going to discuss about some properties of matter. First see the properties of matter: size, shape and density. Size, shape and density in the matters, solid, liquid and gases. See, what is size? That is the volume. That is the volume. What is volume? Volume, space. Space of the matter. Space of the matter. Now I kept in chalk here. So how much space it will occupy? This much space it will occupy. This is called the volume. This is called the volume. Then shape, you know, the shape of the matter. Then density. Density is nothing. This is the mass. Mass. Density means mass. What is mass? What is mass? Mass, quantity of matter. Quantity of matter. So you know, volume, space of matter, density or mass, quantity of matter. So number of particles present in the chalk, that is the mass. Quantity of matter, that means number of particles present in the mass, that is the density. That is the density. So you see, for example, this is solid. So size is there, shape is there, mass is there. Yes, but know already the properties of matter about the liquid and gas. Liquid and gas. In the liquid shape is there, no volume is there. Shape is no shape. Then gas, no. Either volume and the density is there. Volume is not there, size and shape is not there in the gas. So, come in the next one. Change of state due to heat. Change of state due to heat. There, we are going to discuss about few topics. That is, first one is melting point, then melting, then boiling point, vaporization and boiling. Then also four topics there. First, we can see about this melting point. Melting point. You know about the melting process. About the melting process. When we are taking the solid, when we are taking the solid, solid means we can take this as a ice cube. Okay. So for example, see, when this solid supplied heat, the kinetic energy of its particles, the kinetic energy, you know, because it will rotate all time, that is the kinetic energy. The kinetic energy of particles start increase and hence the temperature of the solid start rise. So temperature of the solid will get rise. So certain temperature, in one particular temperature, it will start to melt. In one particular temperature, start to melt. That is called the melting point. That is called the melting point. Shortly, keep your mind. The temperature at which a given solid, which we are giving in the solid, it will start to melt. So the particular point is there, no? It will start to melt in one particular point. The particular point is called the melting point. Melting point. See, then what is melting? What is melting? Nothing. We know already in the solid, if there is no vacant space, there is no vacant space, there is only interparticle space is there. Sorry, interparticle force is there because it's a very tightly packed. Interparticle force is there. Okay? This interparticle force, then it will start to break. When it will start to break, that is the melting. Both are same. This is one particular point, so only they are mentioning the point. Here melting, at this stage, solid start to change into liquid. This is called the melting. This small process, the process is called the melting. Then see the boiling point. See the boiling point. See what is boiling point? The same thing here, but here we can take in the liquid. This is the solid. water. Okay. If the heating of the liquid, continuously further, its temperature start rise again until it reach of certain temperature. So we are going to boil the water. So it's boiling, but it will stop. When it will stop. The starting point is called a boiling point. That is the boiling point. Then see, vapor recession. What is the meaning of vapor recession? Nothing. The same thing in the boiling point what we study. When we are heating the water, here, when it will start to boiling, when it will start to come the vapor up, that starting point is called the vapor recession. Okay, then coming the boiling. Boiling is nothing. We are heating the water, that is called the boiling. We are going to boil the water, that is the boiling, the process. This vaporization takes place. When this vaporization takes place? When we are heating this water, when we are boiling the water. The vaporization takes place at the boiling point, that is called the boiling. Once again, see what is melting point. Melting point is nothing. When we are started to keep any of the solid, going to change into the liquid in the one particular temperature, that is called the melting point. Melting the solid change into liquid, this process is called the melting. Then boiling, we can take in example liquid. When you are going to boiling the water, when it will start to boil, the particular temperature, particular point, that is called the boiling point. Then vapor recession nothing. We are boiling the water, vapor start to come, that is called the vapor recession. Then boiling, simple process. We are going to keep the boiling, we are going to boil the water. So that is the boiling. Understand all? Yes. So we can see in the next topic, next small topic, that is the condensation. See, what is condensation? Now see, listen. What is condensation? You know already. This first I will explain what is that. The reverse process is also possible if heat energy is taken away from the gas. Heat energy taken away from the gas, then it will cool, gas to cool. So see, the particle of gas start losing their kinetic energy. In the liquid, the particles lost the kinetic energy and the matter change into liquid. For example, your mother, she is going to boil 2 cup of water. Just she closed with one cap. When it started to boil, the vapor will come up. It was this vapor settled down upon the cap. Again after 2 minutes, it will change into water droplet. If you are opening the cap and see there some water droplet is there, small particles is there, small drops of the water is there. So that is the condensation, gas to liquid, that is the condensation process. Say a condensation point, it was starting to vapor, then it will start to get one water droplet. That is the condensation point. Then see the freezing. You know already what is freezing. Yes? Freezing. What is freezing? This liquid source formed further becomes solid into cooling. That is the freezing or solidification. Freezing or solidification. So, the example, freezing example. So this condensation point, we know condensation, gas change into liquid. Gas change into liquid. In the freezing, liquid change into solid. Liquid change into solid. When we are taking that water droplet, if we are keeping in the freezer, it will freeze. We will get the solid. So that is the freezing. Then evaporation. Evaporation. What is evaporation? See, in this freezing, the kinetic energy of particle increase the interparticle space, so it will get tight. When we are keeping in the freezer in this liquid, so in this liquid, it will attractive force is there. There is no vacant space. It will attract. After the attraction of the force, we will get this solid. Okay? Then, evaporation. Evaporation. What is evaporation? The process by which a substance changes from the liquid state to gaseous state. Liquid state to gaseous state. That is the evaporation. Okay? This process by which a substance changes from liquid to gaseous state at any temperature. At any temperature. That is called the evaporation. That is called the evaporation. So next we can, evaporations example see. What we can say? Would you have seen water spill down the floor? Water spill in your floor? Yes. When it will disappear? When it will disappear? See, it the vapor station, even though the temperature of the floor is much lower than the boiling point of water. Much lower than the boiling point of water. So where we can hear, see floor, this is the floor. So, water, H2, water. Okay, so this means the floor is much lower than the boiling point of the water. So keep your mind, this floor is much lower than the boiling point of the water. So while boiling in a bulk, when we are boiling a bulk phenomena, this evaporation is a surface phenomena, because that is the evaporation. So coming the next one, factors affecting evaporation. In factors affecting evaporation, what are the topics are there? Temperature, moisture, then surface area, movement of air, sublimation. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 topic is there. See, this is topic. First one is the temperature, moisture, then surface area, movement of air, sublimation. Easy topics. See, the first one is temperature. First one is temperature. Evaporation increase. When the evaporation increase with an increased temperature, this is why cloth dry faster in summer. Cloths dry faster in summer than in winter. Okay, see evaporation. Evaporation means there is heat is there. That keep your mind. Evaporation means there heat is there. So the evaporation increase means heat is increase with an increase in temperature. So temperature increasing, so the evaporation will increase. So only this is why the cloth dry faster in summer than the winter. What is the next topic? Moisture. You know what is moisture? Yes, see moisture. Evaporation will reduce. Evaporation is reduced. Why? Because there is more wet. So, evaporation is reduced with increase in the moisture. Evaporation reduced because increase in the moisture. So, that is example. This is why cloths take longer to dry. That's why the cloth is taking the time to dry. Okay. Then see the surface area. Surface area. What is the meaning of surface area? See, the surface area The longer, longer. So yes. Example, we can see in the outside of the cove, that's floor, because there is more sunlight. You say, think, imagine that. The larger the surface area, the higher is the rate of evaporation. The larger the surface area, the higher is the rate of evaporation. This is why we spread wet cloths for drying. We are not keeping the dressing one place. Yes, we are keeping separate places. We are not putting to dry in one place. We are separating separating the dress cloths into separate places. That is the surface area. Again, I will tell one more time. The larger the surface, more place is there, the area, higher is the rate of evaporation. So evaporation also more. So that is area, surface area. Then movement of air. Movement of air. What is movement of air? See, for we can say air, fast air, wind. Yes, the faster the air move over the liquid, faster the air move over the liquid, the higher is the rate of evaporation. So evaporation is more there. There is why clothes dry fast in windy weather. Yes. So for example, what we can say, if you are any other sarees put into to dry, dry, so it will show. We can see easily a saree is there because the dress will shake. Yes, move one place to another place, here to there. So the faster the air moves over the liquid water, that is the, there is why clothes dry faster in windy weathers. Okay, that is the movement of air. Then sublimation. What is sublimation? What is sublimation? See, sublimation, you see, certain solid directly change into vapor. Certain solid directly change into gas. Directly change into gas. This process by which a substance changes from the solid state to gaseous state directly without going liquid. Okay, so solid directly change into gas. Between liquid is there, but it will not go there. Straightly turn into gas. So that is called the sublimation. So in this process, solid directly change into gas. That is called the sublimation. That is called the sublimation. Then you can see some of the sublimation's examples. So see, some of the sublimation solid we can take iodine, then ammonium chloride, naphthalene ball solid, carbon dioxide and air fresheners. So when we are taking these all the example things, for example, we can take naphthalene ball. You will get easily in the form that naphthalene ball, if you are taking to heat, that is solid, directly change into gas. Directly change into gas. It will not go here in the liquid. So which solid is directly change into gas, this process is called the sublimation. This process is called sublimation. Okay students, I hope you understand what I taught today. We can see in the next class. Thank you.